Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at a new feature in Pages that allows you to rearrange things in your document using sections. So Apple recently released new versions of Pages, Numbers, and Keynote. And there are a lot of small new features in these. I'm going to look at one today. And I'm using Pages version 5.6. And I'm just going to create a new blank document. And in the past, I could certainly look at the page thumbnails here on the left and see what pages I've done, but I couldn't really rearrange them. They're basically just a way for me to jump from page to page. But now with Pages 5.6, I can actually rearrange them in a way that you might do, say if you're writing a story and you want to have sections that you rearrange, or perhaps a script, or perhaps notes for class, things like that. And you kind of want to rearrange the sheets of paper. And you can do that using sections. So let's start off by just creating a bunch of pages that may have some notes on them. So here's three potential pages, and I could easily select at the end here and say insert a page break to create a new page, and you can see these are on separate pages. But I'm not going to do that. Instead, I'm going to insert a section break. And it seems to do the same thing. I get first page here and second page with that, and I'm going to actually insert another section break there. And it seems like, well, I just have three pages. But there's a big difference. The difference is, notice when I select one of these, I get this yellow outline. And that's because one page is an entire section. And by it being a section, I could do something I can't do if these were simply pages. I could rearrange them. So I could take this one here, this one that has the text page 2, and I could click and drag it above, and now I've rearranged these. So I start with page 2, page 1, and page 3. Now let's make this into a little nicer format so I can really work with it. So first thing I want to do is I want to grab this line here and I'm going to shrink it a bit so I could see more pages. Also, I'm going to select all the text and I'm going to increase its size to something where I can see it a little easier. So I'm going to make that larger right there. And since I've selected all before, they're all larger. So I can kind of see them a little bit better here. I also can change the size of the page here. So I'm going to do horizontal there instead. And I can even do a custom size, or I can just do something like a postcard. And now you can see I can see these a little bit better, and I can see multiple ones on the screen at the same time. So they're easier to move around as notes. So I can now rearrange these notes however I want over here. And I can also delete them as well. I have one selected. I can hit the delete key and you can see it'll ask to confirm that delete right there. I can also insert a new one. I don't have to go and type more stuff here and then do insert section break. I can actually click here and then insert section, and we'll put a new section after the one I'm currently in. So now I've got this one here. And now these can all be rearranged. Now since these are sections, sections can have multiple pages in them. So let's go here to this one, page 3, and I'll actually add more text. And you can see how it does it here on the left. I have this whole section. I can select the entire thing at once and it moves together as a section. So I can put it here at the end. So you could very easily have a lot more detail in one of these notes than in the rest of them. And they can still all be moved around. This could be deleted here and it will tell me it's going to delete pages 1 through 4. So it's very useful if you have things that are just one page worth of notes, or you have some sections that are multiple pages worth of notes.